Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host, Deepa Soman, and these are the major news stories of Monday, February 12, 2024. Plunging Congress into a crisis, Maharashtra ex-CM Ashok Chauhan quit the party. He has resigned from the primary membership, and it is rumored that he would join the BJP. Massive explosion at a firecracker storage rocked Tripunithura. One person was killed while several persons were injured in the blast. Houses in a 2-kilometer radius suffered damage. Police have imposed Section 144 across Delhi ahead of the Delhi Chalo march called by the farmers. The national capital also saw huge security deployment, multi-layered barricading at borders to stop the farmers. Nitish Kumar-led NDA government has won the trust vote in Bihar Assembly. Israeli forces rescued 2 hostages in a dramatic Gaza raid that killed at least 67 Palestinians. Let's get into the details. Plunging the Congress in the state into a crisis ahead of the general election, former Maharashtra Chief Minister Ashok Chauhan quit the Congress on Monday. Speculations are rife that he is veering towards the BJP. In a letter to the state Congress President Nana Patole, the 65-year-old said he was resigning as a primary member of the party. He also submitted his resignation as an MLA to Assembly Speaker Rahul Narvekar. Chauhan said he has not taken any decision yet on joining the ruling BJP and will decide on his next political move in a couple of days. I'm not a person who would discuss the party's internal matters publicly. I have not spoken to any Congress MLA about my decision. I have no such intention, he said. He also said his decision to quit the Congress is a personal one and he does not want to ascribe any reason to it. Chauhan also refuted the claims that the white paper tabled in Parliament prompted him to resign from Congress. A person was killed and nearly 16 people sustained injuries in a massive explosion in Tripunithura on Monday. The explosion happened at a firecracker storage operated in a house in Churakkad. Nearby houses and buildings were also damaged in the blast. The deceased is identified as 27-year-old Thiruvananthapuram native Vishnu. According to reports, Vishnu was the driver of the vehicle that carried the firecrackers to the storage house at Churakkad. He suffered severe burns in the explosion. According to reports, firecrackers were taken to the residential area for fireworks at the nearby Pudiyakavu temple. However, the district authority and police have confirmed that neither the temple committee nor any person sought permission to store firecrackers in the house at Churakkad. Meanwhile, police clarified that they have denied permission for fireworks at Pudiyakavu temple. On Sunday, police registered a case against the temple committee for a firework display without seeking permission. A vacant house in the residential area was apparently converted into a godown for storing the firecrackers. This house and the vehicle that carried the explosives were completely destroyed in the blast. As per the preliminary inquiry, the firecrackers exploded due to the extreme heat. Massive deployment of police and paramilitary personnel besides multi-layered barricading have taken place to seal the national capital borders at Singu, Tikri and Ghazipur. This is to prevent the protesting farmers from entering the capital city during their scheduled Delhi Chalo march on Tuesday. The Delhi police has imposed prohibitory orders for a month banning entry of procession of tractors, truck or other vehicles in the city. Several farmer associations, mostly from Uttar Pradesh, Haryana and Punjab, have called for the march on February 13th to demand a law guaranteeing MSP for their produce. It was one of the conditions they had set when they agreed to withdraw their agitation in 2021. Meanwhile, prohibitory orders under Section 144 of the Criminal Procedure Code have been enforced in the Northeast District of Delhi to maintain law and order. The newly formed NDA government in Bihar on Monday won the trust vote in the State Assembly amid a walkout by members of the Mahagathbandhan. In the 243-strong assembly, a total of 129 members voted in favour of the motion of confidence. Deputy Speaker Maheshwar Hazari was in the chair when the voting took place. Hazari ordered a head count after having declared the motion as passed through voice vote. This was following a request from Parliamentary Affairs Minister Vijay Kumar Chaudhary, which was seconded by Chief Minister Nitish Kumar. Kumar had recently dumped the Mahagathbandhan, of which the RJD was a key constituent, and returned to the NDA fold to form the government with support of the BJP. Israeli forces rescued two hostages early Monday, storming a heavily guarded apartment in the Gaza Strip. They extracted the captives under fire in a dramatic raid that was a small but symbolically significant success for Israel. The operation killed at least 67 Palestinians, including women and children, according to Palestinian health officials in the beleaguered territory. To assist the rescue forces, heavy airstrikes pounded the area near the apartment in Rafah, a city on the southern edge of the Gaza Strip. The raid was celebrated in Israel as a victory in the sluggish battle to free the hostages. More than 100 captives are still held by Hamas and other Gaza militants. In Gaza, where civilians have borne a staggering toll since the war erupted on October 7th, the operation unleashed another wartime tragedy with many Palestinians killed or wounded. More than 12,300 Palestinian minor children and younger teens have been killed in Israel's war against Hamas, the health ministry in Hamas-run Gaza said on Monday. That means minors make up about 43% of the total number of 28,176 Palestinians killed so far. About 8,400 women were also among those killed. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Deepa Soman, and produced by Vishnu Muralidharan, with technical support from Idea Brew Studios. Follow on manorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news, and be sure to come back tomorrow.